Hi there, I'm Tony Tamarchio, Head of Technical Operations and Support here at 8th Wall. In this video, you'll learn how to implement advanced features in 8th Wall and discover different resources and communities that will guide you along the way. Let's dive in and begin our first project. First, navigate to your workspace and click on Start a New Project. We will need to set the project URL as well as the project title. For this walkthrough, let's name it My First WebAR Experience and click Create to continue. Next, choose a project from the Quick Start menu. In the 8th Wall Templates section, we can filter projects by type and framework. Let's choose World Effects as the type and A-Frame for our preferred framework. Scroll down or use the search bar to locate the A-Frame Tap Place project. This example allows you to place 3D models by tapping on the surface in front of you. Click the Clone Project button to start with this template. Once the project is created and our template is cloned, we're ready to start developing. The pane on the left side of the Cloud Editor shows files, assets, and modules associated with your project. Every Cloud Editor project is composed of three main files, head.html, app.js, and body.html. The Files section allow you to add additional files such as custom JavaScript code, CSS, and more. In the Assets section, you can upload mixed media files such as images, videos, and 3D models. The current template already contains a handful of assets that we'll use in this walkthrough. The bottom of the pane contains project modules. We will add a module later on. To upload files or assets, click the plus buttons or drag and drop files onto the panel. Let's take a look at the three default files present in every Cloud Editor project. Head.html is used to import packages and libraries into a project. In this file, you should be adding script tags for external libraries such as tween.js, Google Analytics, A-Frame Extras, or others. 8th Wall provides common libraries via meta tags. These meta tags are provided as a convenience, so you don't have to worry about remembering full URLs. They're automatically replaced by script tags when you build your project. Here, we use meta tags to load the A-Frame library, 8th Wall's XRExtras package, and the landing page package. Later, we'll add a basic script tag to load in an external library. In A-Frame projects, the body.html contains visible elements in our experience, including 2D UI elements like div or buttons, and 3D scene entities like primitives or models. Every A-Frame scene must have a camera. We also need a light and other entities. This particular template uses a transparent box that acts as a virtual ground object to receive tap interactions. Let's test our project by clicking the preview button. Scan the QR code to preview the AR experience on your phone or open it in a 3D desktop mode by clicking here. After accepting browser permissions, the camera feed will open. By tapping on the screen, a cactus will appear on the surface at the tap location. Let's make some changes by swapping the 3D model from a cactus to a flower. First, we need to drag flower.glb to the assets folder. Now, let's swap out the path to the newly uploaded 3D asset of the flower model in body.html and click Save and Build. The Cloud Editor rebuilds your project and your phone will automatically reload. Our changes are then reflected in our preview. This is a great feature for iterating quickly. Let's make this AR experience more interesting by activating the animations included in the flower 3D model. To do this, we'll use A-Frame's Animation Mixer component. This is part of the A-Frame Extras library, so first we'll need to go into head.html and add the script tag. Playing an animation from your 3D model is as simple as adding a new attribute to an entity. In this case, the Animation Mixer component plays animation clips contained in the model. Since we are creating new 3D models dynamically, we need to add that logic to our code. Open the tap2place.js file and add a new line within the model loaded code block, so the Animation Mixer component is added to the new element once it's created. The Flower 3D model contains an animation clip named Bounce, so we'll specify that in our code. Click Save and Build to update your project. When the build is complete, your phone will reload and you can see the changes. Now, when the Flower 3D models spawn, they're animated. 8th Wall has developed a library called XRExtras, which provides pre-built components for common behaviors and interactions. This includes things like gesture controls, loading screens, and other common WebAR needs. Our project contains several XRExtras components. For example, XRExtras Loading manages the loading screen and almost there workflow. Let's add another component so we can interact with the 3D models in our scene. In body.html, add the XRExtras Gesture Detector component to your A-scene. This component enables gestures such as hold drag, pinch scale, and rotation. To showcase XRExtras in action, let's add another model to our experience. I've uploaded a 3D model of a robot and added it to A-assets. Here, I copied and pasted the asset code we use for the flower. We'll then replace the ID and file name to match our robot asset. Next, add the robot model to the scene as an entity using the GLTF model component referencing its asset ID. Add the animation mixer component just like we did for the flowers. And finally, add the XRExtras hold drag component to the robot. Click Save and Build once more to update your project. When the build is complete, your phone will reload again. The robot will be visible in the scene immediately, and when you place your finger over it and drag, you can move it around. You can still tap the ground to place flowers. Eighth Wall modules allow you to develop reusable components for your projects. Eighth Wall has an existing library of modules, and you can also create your own. In this example, we will update our project to include the Reflections module, a module that can add either static or real-time reflections of your environment to 3D objects in your scene. Add the Reflections module to your project by clicking on the plus sign next to the Modules panel. Here, you can find a list of modules available to import. Select the Reflections module and click the Import button. Adding reflections to a 3D model is as simple as adding a new attribute to the entity. Add the Reflections component directly to the robot entity in body.html. In this case, Reflections equals type realtime. Save and build one last time, and now we can see the reflections applied to the robot 3D model. Now that we have a working project, it's time to deploy it to the web. Initially, we might want to share this project with coworkers or clients to gather their feedback, but we don't yet want the project to be publicly available. To achieve this, Eighth Wall provides both public and password-protected staging URLs for each project. You have full control over where you deploy and when. First, let's prepare our code for deployment. As you can see on the top right corner of the Cloud Editor, there are two buttons, Land and Publish. The Land button takes your changes and commits them into the Cloud Editor's integrated source control system. This step is required before you can publish your project to the web. Let's commit our code changes by clicking on Land. In the next screen, you can see which files have been modified and also view the specific changes. Add a commit message so other developers on your team can understand what you've changed. Finally, click the Land Files button. To deploy the project, you need to click on Publish. The first time you publish, it will ask you to fill in the required details about your project, such as title, cover image, and description. Then, on the Publish Project panel, we can see the different versions of code that have been landed and select which one we want published to the staging or public links. The public URL is your final link, where everyone around the world can access your experience. The staging URL is a password-protected link for coworkers or clients to test your experience privately before launch. Only users with a password will be able to access your WebAR experience via the staging link. By using the radio buttons, you'll be able to pick and choose which changes will be served on either of those links. Simply click Publish and your WebAR experience will be instantly available at the public or staging URLs. In just a few minutes, we've covered all the steps required to develop your first Eighth Wall WebAR experience. If you want to take a deeper look at the platform's capabilities, visit eighthwall.com/docs for the documentation and API reference. We can't wait to see what you'll create next. Thanks for watching and happy building.